Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? We finished up that field, and I'm just on my way down to the bottom yard so that I can store the very last of this canola, because we do have a little bit more in storage there, so I'll pop it all in together and then we can always take it and sell it another day. I was just asked, someone noticed that the sound is quite a bit different on my last episode, and it will be on this one as well. I've sorted out the sort of the issues that I was having with getting the sound levels right in this game. I'm doing my recording slightly differently now, and this is kind of how it's going to be from now on with not only this game but any other games I'm doing as well. So hopefully you think it's an improvement. I think it's an improvement, but yeah, you guys can be the judge of that. Anyway, the question that I asked yesterday, I said would be answered in episode 4 or something equally ridiculous. It won't be. Yesterday's question about which combine you want is going to be for episode 6. Now, the question for today was, do you want me to concentrate on mostly arable, mostly animal husbandry, I should say, or would you like me to do an even mix of the two? And the answers are in. You would like me to do an even mix of the two. Now, I've been doing a lot of combining lately, and as such, I've decided it's probably time to do something a bit different. So I'm just going to... Now, where do I tip this stuff? This is going to be the next thing. Let me just hop out a second. I know that I've got... Right, there's a silage clamp there. And this is... I think this is a storage for oats, maybe? I think that's an oat storage. Let's just take a look in here. What's in this one? Right, that's something else. And what's in this one? Ah, right. Here we have canola. So I'm going to tip the canola in here. And is there anything else that we can tip into, or have you got to just back into the shed and tip there? I think you've got to back into the shed and tip. Not run out onto the road and kill ourselves. Right, yes, it does look like we've got to tip straight into the shed. So now we've got to see if I can back up this trailer, because if I can't, I'm going to be doing a lot of selling straight to the market. Let's just take the cover off. Can I just drive in round? That would be a lot easier. Perhaps if I just go in round. Yeah, okay. No reversing required. I can just go straight in round and I can tip right here. Go on, then. Straight onto the heap. And now we have a problem in that the heap will grow. So today I'm going to get some animals. And I'm thinking that I'm just going to start with a few sheep and a few cows. I don't want too many. I do want a few though. And I'm going to get, I would say probably just 10 milking cows. Oh, no, I want to come over here. There, that's that one. And then I come over here for that one. Close them both up. Excellent. Right. I'm going to go into our shop and let's place our order for our cows. So we have our animals. We've got, I would like some chickens. I would like chickens around the yard. The cows are very expensive, are 2,500 each. So I'm only going to get 10 of these to start with, I think. Any more than that, and it's just going to cost us way too much money. 7, 8, 9, and 10. So we're not going to get huge quantity of those. I'm going to get some chickens. The pigs and the beef animals, I'm not going to get those yet. I'm going to get some sheep and I'm going to get some chickens. If I get, say, how many should we get? Right, 10 is going to be 3,000. So 20 would be 30 grand. That's a bit much. 100 would be. So if we get 50 sheep, and I'm also going to get 50 chickens. Well, that's 50 chickens, 50 sheep, and 10 cows. You know, I think we're going to double that, actually. We're going to go for 20 cows so that we do have a few to do something with. It's not a huge amount. There we go. Right, so we have 20 cows, 50 sheep, and 50 chickens. We will get the other animals another time. What we need to do now is we need to be able to... Well, first of all, we need to find out where they are. The sheep are just behind us. I can hear them. So let's see. I think they're in this field here. I think we just go through this one. Oop. And right through the gate there. Right, let's take a run up through here. Yes, right, so the sheep are in this one right behind the sheds here. And I don't believe that you have to put wool in... wool? Well, I'm reading wool on the side here. Let's just get rid of that because that's distracting me. Yeah, I don't think you have to actually give the animals water on this map. Which is a little bit of a shame because it does break the immersion ever so slightly, but that's okay. We can work with that. And I'm also thinking that actually we'll just bring a mower into this field and we'll mow a little bit of this grass so that we can then pick it up with a forager and feed it direct to them. But where is the pallet for the wool? That's the only thing, is where do I collect the pallet? I've got a tipping point there. And I've got this. Is that it there, where that other tipping point is there? Or that just telling me where the grains are? I think it's telling me where the grains are. Well, once we've got a little bit of wool down, we'll be able to hunt that one out so we can find it. So let's just shut the gate here a minute before we let any sheep out. And then I think we need to go and get a mower so that we can cut some grass. And then we're also going to need a forager. So, yeah, the forage wagon. We got that. It's all back at the yard. We can go and get all of these things and we can bring them back down here and start putting some of the... Get a bit of grass into their trough, and we'll do the same with the cows. Let's just make sure that we can get... I wonder if the wool actually is there somewhere. It might be. But we have chickens all over the place in here now. And I think the cows actually go in there. We've got the... What do you call the bedding machine for spreading the straw in? I can't remember what that's called, actually. It's just a straw shredder, isn't it? I think it's just a straw shredder. Right. Let's drive around all these chickens. I'm going to stick this trailer here undercover, and I'm going to do it without having to bother to do any reversing, because I don't like trying to reverse that one. I'm going to leave the cover on it and put that one there. So we've got the forage wagon there. I did say that we would take the mower and everything all the way down to... I think the mower is actually around the back. I said we would take it all down to where the sheep are, but I don't think we will. I think we'll actually just go through to field two and we'll cut that one. Because we've got all the equipment right here, he says, right here. All the equipment is round here. No. All the equipment is round here. Yes, there it is. Right. All the equipment is just around here, just like I was saying. So I'll get the mower and we'll cut the grass and then... Oops. It would help if I was going the right way. There we go. Right, we'll pick up the mower and we'll cut the grass in field two and then we'll row it up with the rake there. And then finally we will collect it up with the forage wagon. We will put some for the cows here and then we'll take the rest down and we'll put that in for the sheep. And how do we get into... well, I was going to do field two because it was right here and convenient, but it's just been cut. If you have a look in there, that one is still growing. Let's take a look at our information. Come through here. Right, no, I don't want that. I want this one here. Right, so field two is growing. This one here is ready to harvest. Five... I'm not really sure what that pattern is. I guess that's just, you know, the stubble. 28 is growing, 42. Right, so what have we got? I suppose I could cut a little bit for the... in the cow's field, in behind number three here. I think that's what we're going to have to do, because that's the closest one. I don't want to have to take everything all the way down here for the sheep's pasture, even though the sheep's field is pretty big. So let's go into field three. Let's just back up here a bit. An old combine. Is that a combine there? I think that's an old combine. I love the wrecks and stuff that we've got lying around in this map. I think it's such an awesome touch. Right, field three is the cow's field. And we will also use this field for cutting some grass. We've got it right here, so we may as well use it, because we've only got 20 cows and they're not going to use all of this just yet. So we'll cut a patch of it for us. We're not going to need any more than one wagon full, I wouldn't have thought. So let's get through the gate. And come in here. Let's just hop out a minute and Shut the gate. Back out the way. Oh, okay. That was pretty poor driving on my part. I shouldn't have parked it right in front of the gate. Now, where are we going to cut? I would say we'll just cut a piece down here. We'll go a little way in, and then we'll sort of start from about here, I think. And we'll cut a little slice up through this side. So let's just unfold this mower. I think this tractor will probably handle it okay. This isn't a bad tractor. I don't like the interior. I don't like the cab. It's not very comfortable. But overall, it's not a bad machine. So let's drop that one down. Start the mower up. No, I don't want to go backwards. Does it have a swathing option? No, it doesn't. Okay. Now, I do like having the weeds in the map. I think the weeds is a brilliant idea. You've got the thistles through. The one thing I don't like, however, is that, unfortunately, it's got to be a separate crop. So you can't actually cut it. Which kind of spoils the effect a little bit, but it does mean that we at least don't get loads of thistles into our grass that we're feeding our animals. They get carefully pulled out. Now, I'm not going to do a huge chunk of this field. I'm just going to do a slice of it down through. I'm going to leave a tree in the middle so that we've got to go round it, just for a bit more realism. And I would say that a piece like this is probably all that we're actually going to need. Now, you'll notice that I am driving on some of the crop, and the correct way to do a field normally, out the way, cow. Grief. Normally, you would do the field like this, so now that the tractor is straddling the cut line, and go right the way round and just keep doing this, and then at the very end you go the opposite way round, you go the anti-clockwise, and that will pick up the last run, the one that you've already driven on, and you've given it a bit of time to sort of recover and start standing upright. And because you're going the opposite direction that the wheels went, it actually cuts through and picks it up fairly cleanly, and you don't normally get left with any wheel marks down through the field. So I will just finish out this patch, I think. Come on, cow. Out of the way. Yeah, and you as well. This isn't very helpful, you know. And now I'll just get the outside round. A little bit more. I may even do two outside rounds. Just to make sure that we've got enough grass. I don't want to be left with not enough. And we can always store a little bit for now in the forage wagon. I think that would probably be about enough. We'll call it a day with that. And turn that one off. And that can fold up while I'm driving back down here. Just going to go and get the rake. Well, that was a little bit odd. It wouldn't let me unhitch the mower while it was folded up. And we did collect it while it was folded up, but I guess it just didn't like it any further. So we'll just have to leave it unfolded now. It seems a bit untidy, really. I think it would be better if it could be in the up position, sort of supported up on chocks or something. Anyway, now the difficult bit is going to be getting this one out of this shed. I'm hoping it's got steering assistance. Steering assistance is when the wheels on the trailer, the wheels on the back, I think it does. It goes on a three-point linkage, which means that it's, as you turn, the wheels turn. Yeah, they do. So steering assistance is good, so long as you're not tight to a wall, because it will swing right into the wall. Like he's doing there. But the rest of it is all right. He'll see, he swings out round. It means that you can get round tighter corners with it, which is a lot more convenient. All right, let's whip up through here. I'm going to hope that these cows aren't going to try to escape while we leave this gate open. I'm just going to risk it this time. It's a terrible risk, but it is something that I'm going to do. Now then, come up to here and unfold the windrower, or the rake, whichever you want to call it. That is ready. Now lower. Now I've got cows in the way. Okay. Right, well, it seems to be working. We'll gather this up. I think I'm going to have to wait a while for this cow to move out of the way. It takes the corners very nicely here. That's the steering assistance. So it means that you don't have to swing out round really far on the bends. And you've got to remember that you don't need to swing in a long way on the bends either. Excuse me, cow. These cows are stubborn on this map. I think probably better if we don't cut the grass in here too often, because they keep getting in the way and I've got to get out and chase them out the way every so often. He's moved right back again. I shooed him out the way just now and he's right back there again already. Okay, stop there and we lift the wind rower. Now the other problem with steering assistance is that when you reverse the machine, it does try to do crazy things as you go backwards. Right, let's try dropping it right there and hope we're far enough back. That'll do it. That little bit we can pick up on its own. Let the way, cow. Right, this should just be one run down through. We're going to quite reach it all. Ooh, nice. Look at that. Whole lot, all in one go. Another cow on the way. We can pick up that little bit there. I'm not sure, actually, if we're going to have enough grass here, to be honest. We'll see in a minute. This seemed like a good idea when I started. Oh, we got it now. I think I can do it. Yes. That was not easy, shunting that back in there. That was not easy at all. I'm quite pleased with myself. There, I've got to be honest, I really am. Okay, let's go and get the forage wagon. I think that is around the front here somewhere, isn't it? We've got a big silage bay there. It's going to be difficult filling that one up because of the access on front. Now, where is that forage wagon? Got chickens here. Out of the way, chickens. Chickens all over the place. So I hope we're not going to be driving into the eggs. I would like to see, in the future, I would like to see the chickens running out the way when you drive through. I'd like to see them react to the tractors. I think that would be absolutely fantastic. If they raced out the way when you came flying into the yard, that would be awesome. Right, let's go and get that grass. Okay, let's switch this one on. Oh, lower that one. Now switch him on. And away we go. How much are we going to get from this little bit of field? I've got a feeling that we may have needed to get more than this. But it seems all right. It's filling up. We got 2,000 litres already. And remember, we've only got 20 cows, haven't we? We can put the rest in for the sheep. And we can always go and cut a bit more next time if we need to. Come out round here. Normally when I'm playing on my own, I actually come outside the cab to do this particular job. I find it a bit easier on the top because then I can at least see where the pickup's going as well. I'll try it with a bit of both, I think. I've got 8,000 litres now. We're not doing too bad. Let's come outside here for this one. Swing up round. There we go. Right, now I'm going to go whirling in circles here. This. The advantage that we're in the cow's field already is that we can just nip over to the trough and see how much of this that we can put straight into them. I need to swing round again. I don't want to leave any behind. I absolutely hate leaving little patches of hay or straw. Well, the straw's not so bad because once you go over it with a cultivator or the plough, it just gets ploughed back in. But absolutely, really? Really? No fear. That's the problem. I really don't like leaving little patches of hay or grass around because whatever happens, it's there to stay, pretty much. You don't often fill any of... You don't often sort of plow the areas back in again. So I will try to pick up everything if I can. Right, that's all that lot. 11 tons. That's pretty good, I'd say. And I'm just doing the simple conversion that it is 1,000 litres per ton. It could be wrong. And if it is, I apologise for my terrible inaccuracies. I missed a tiny little bit. Right there. Got it. Right, that is all of the grass. That is everything. Every little tiny little last drop. And, oh, there's the trough over there. Let's just turn the machine off. Head over here. Does it matter which side that we approach this one from? I don't think it does. Although, well, if the cows are coming into it from the dirtied side. I would assume it would be better to tip from this side. Let's have a look. We'll have to. We may end up having to try the other side as well. But so I've got 12 tons. I'm not going to put more than half of it in here if I can help it. Right, well, that seems to want to tip okay. How much are we going to put in? Right, I've just stopped it there. I'm not going to put any more in. Let's bring up this one. So now we have 6,074 litres of grass. So our productivity at the moment is on 5%. And our grass is saying 6,000 litres. So let's head down to the sheep and give them the last of this grass. And we can always come back and get some more another time. We've also productivity... Oh, wool is still 0%, so I'm not sure if we've got... we still don't know where the map is. Oh, where the wool is going to be. That's the next thing we need to find out. Well, that answers a question as to where the wool goes. Actually, that is really convenient, because if it's right there, what's it saying now? It's still 0%. But, yeah, if the wool is right there, it does mean we should be able to store it in that shed. I don't think that shed is used for storing anything else. Which was the sheep field? Don't drive into that one, Frith. There we go. The sheep field is this one up here, so we need to go up and into here so that we can get the... open the gate. I keep standing on the wrong side of the gates. Right, let's go and feed these sheep, then that should take their productivity up. Well, you don't notice it straight away on our little animal display. By the way, if you want to know where that mod comes from, it's operated with the asterisks on the keypad, on the number pad on the side of the keyboard. That mod is the animal display, I think it's an animal display mod or something like that. It's from the Farming Simulator main website. It's actually really handy. I mean, yes, it's not in English, or at least the animals' names aren't in English, but the rest of it is. And it is. I really like it. I use this one all the time. Right, there we go. It would have been better if I'd approached this from the top side. But it does display every animal and all the different things you've got. I don't think it's compatible with the beef and pig mods. But that's okay. We can live with that. I've still got 179 litres in here, which we will give to the cows. I'll go and put this... That's really it for today, I think. We've done this. I've got to take this back up to the other yard and put it away. Because if I empty this out, we can then use it for the straw after we harvest the oats. Because it's the oats that we're going to be harvesting next. This tractor... This is the other thing. This tractor is a nice little runaround. But I do want something that is going to be a little bit better. Can I do it from this side? I can't. I'll come over here. There we go. Move out of the way. Right, that tractor is nice and all, but I'd like to get another one. And I've never really gotten that many tractor mods. We've got that little one there. And we've also got this one. And the other one we've got is this one with a front loader on it. And that is at one of the other yards. That's where the beef and the pigs are. Now, I've use these a lot. What I'm thinking... No, I don't want to do that. I want to go here, and I'm going to go into our mods. I've got a whole load of different tractors. Now, we don't want anything like this. We don't need a 400-horsepower tractor. Not for this farm. That's too big a tractor for this farm. These case machines are very nice, though. Now, what I'm thinking is that perhaps something like this one... This is a 200... this is a slightly modern version of the same one, isn't it? So that's a 400 horsepower tractor. I don't think we need that. This here, this case, this is quite a nice tractor. It performs well, and overall, I think that's quite a nice one. And we've got some quite old machinery here. We've got this John Deere. I'm not that impressed with that one. It doesn't grip very well. This is a very old Russian one, which we don't want. It's extremely uncomfortable to drive. And then we've got these two. We've got a 370 horsepower John Deere tractor here, which is actually really good. Possibly a bit on the big side for this map. This one here, though, this is a 250 horsepower Lamborghini. Now, I've never driven a Lamborghini before. So I'm thinking it's going to be a choice between a Lamborghini and... Where is it? This case here. This is a 200 horsepower one. And the Lamborghini here is 250. So that is my question for today. Do you want me to get the Lamborghini, or do you want me to get the case? You decide. So we'll say case is option one, Lamborghini is option two. You let me know which one you want me to get, and that will be our main tractor for this farm. I'm going to take this on up to the yard. You let me know which you prefer, the case or the Lamborghini. Number one for the case, number two for the Lamborghini. If you enjoyed the video, then please head down below and give me a like. That would be really cool. If you really enjoyed it, I'd appreciate it if you could tell your friends all about me, because that would be simply awesome. But thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.